Hello and welcome to the second part of this unit where we will discuss about liquid hydrogen storage technology. Liquid hydrogen has a gravimetric and energetic density much higher than that of hydrogen in gaseous state. Thus, with the liquefaction of hydrogen, a greater volume reduction is achieved than that with compression, overcoming most of the problems related to the weight and size of gas storage systems. Hydrogen cryogenic technology is not as widespread as compressed hydrogen, but it has reached a high level of maturity and maintains a significant market share. The saturation temperature of hydrogen at 1 atmosphere is about -253 degrees Celsius. This is the maximum temperature at which hydrogen exists as a liquid at ambient pressure, and must therefore be maintained in order to store it in that state. This presents two problems: to reach this temperature and to maintain it. The most frequently used condensation process is the Linde method, a simplest liquefaction process that we can see in this figure. It requires the supply of hydrogen gas at low temperature of -99.15 degrees Celsius for the system to start operating. This low temperature can be supplied from liquid nitrogen, which is found at -195 degrees Celsius at atmospheric pressure, obtained in an auxiliary plant. The Linde cycle or Joule-Thomson expansion cycle consists of four stages. In the first step, the gas passes through a compressor where its pressure increases at room temperature. Then the gas is cooled in a heat exchanger to the temperature of liquid nitrogen, that is -195 degrees Celsius. Later on, the gas is passed through a throttle valve and as it expands to constant enthalpy, liquid hydrogen is generated and extracted from the cycle. The last state consists on recirculating the remaining gases and heated in the same countercurrent heat exchanger before entering the compressor again. In general, it can be said that the liquefaction process demands between 30 and 40% of the chemical energy of the stored hydrogen in terms of low heating value. On the other hand, the energy consumption demanded by the system that maintain the temperature is between 1 and 2% of the stored energy. Liquid hydrogen is stored at such low temperature in vacuum isolated tanks or in double layers tanks containing another intermediate cryogenic fluid such as liquid nitrogen. In any case, any heat transfer between the contained liquid hydrogen and the environment must be minimized. It is impossible to store hydrogen in liquid form indefinitely, since even the best insulation does not prevent some heat from being transferred from the environment. This causes part of the hydrogen to evaporate and the pressure in the tank to increase. Therefore, the tanks have a maximum overpressure capacity of approximately 5 bars, so that if hydrogen is not consumed as quickly as it vaporizes, the pressure exceeds the safety level by opening a relief valve through which it is vented. This situation not only leads to the direct loss of usable fuel, but also poses a flammability risk if the exhaust occurs in an enclosed space. In cryogenic tanks, insulation often involves the use of a second vessel around the tank. The supporting structures and interconnections between the vessels must allow and support the contraction and expansion that will occur each time the vessel is filled and empty. The complexity of this structure increases as the tanks become larger. The materials used are carbon steel for the outer tank and stainless steel or aluminium for the inner vessel, as well as for other connections. Insulating layers can be placed between the two vessels, although this can increase heat transfer by conduction compared to vacuum. The total weight of this type of tanks is around 50 and 60 kg, and the maximum operating pressure is 0.6 MPa. The process of refilling cryogenic tanks is not a problem per se. However, the lines need to be thermostated. Therefore, the need for refrigeration system and compressor makes the overall process more complicated than storing compressed hydrogen. Nevertheless, cryogenic storage has the advantage that the working pressure is relatively low and the volumes required to store the same amount of hydrogen are much lower. Even so, liquid hydrogen storage system can be 4 to 10 times larger and heavier than an equivalent tank of gasoline. Currently, a hybrid system between compression and liquefaction, the so-called cryo-compressed hydrogen, is now being studied. It contains gaseous hydrogen under pressure, but at a cryogenic temperature of -196.15 degrees Celsius, achieved by liquid nitrogen. This system has similar volumetric performance as liquefied hydrogen, but considerably reduces evaporation losses as well as the energy consumed. With this, we conclude the part of the unit about the liquid hydrogen storage possibilities.